Welcome to our Rescue Experience Center. My name is Rens de Jonge and I'm a rescue consultant for Holmatro. Today we're going to take a look at our brand new full range of high pressure lifting bags. The 12 new models operate at 12 bar or 174 psi. The smaller and lighter lifting bags are easier to manage, especially with this new integrated carrying handle. Imprinted on the carrying handle is the model number of the bag. The model number corresponds with the lifting capacity. On the smaller bags, like this one, the capacity is imprinted on the side. The lifting capacity is also marked on the front of the bag, along with other important information like safety warnings and working pressure. As these lifting bags are used all over the world, the information is displayed in various units of measure. This data matrix here links to the free Holmatro service portal, where you will find important maintenance and inspection information. My personal favorite new addition to the labels is this arrow, giving you a visual indication of the lifting height, which makes it easier to select the right bag for the job. Now that we've established that this is the correct size, we can connect the hose. As the air inlet is positioned in line with the side of the bag, it requires less storage space. It also means that it is less likely to get damaged compared to air inlets sticking out from the corner of a bag. With the air inlet pointing straight out, it is also easier to place the bag underneath the load at a right angle. Another new feature that makes positioning the bags easier is the slider pad. These smooth pads are especially helpful to insert larger bags on a rough surface. The lifting bags also have an insert for an eyelet on two sides, making vertical placement easier. Both sides of the bags have a non-slip design for maximum grip and reflective markings for improved visibility in the dark. This center cross is also reflective, but if you take a closer look, you will see it is also an interlocking profile. It maximizes the contact area and stability when you stack two lifting bags on top of each other. The center cross isn't always easily visible. To position the bags correctly, we have also put centering marks on all sides of the bags to help you align them. It is recommended to put a smaller bag on top of a larger one for maximum stability. Now let's take a look at this brand new lightweight control unit. It has been designed for easy, intuitive operation. You can connect two lifting bags to this control unit. There is also an additional pressure gauge for your air source. All three pressure gauges are LED illuminated for easier operation in poorly lighted areas. The new controller also has two built-in non-return valves, which is important for controlled lifting. Each bag is inflated individually and no air can flow from one bag to the other. Safe and controlled lifting was very important in the development of this new range. This switch allows you to regulate airflow in a controlled way for safe and smooth operation. And since it looks a bit like a game controller, Ronald easily takes controlled lifting to the next level. Operating lifting bags has never been easier. Thanks for keeping my glass full. Like I said, it's all about control, and that goes for unlocking the hoses as well. In other systems, the sudden release of air may lead to uncontrolled hose movement. So the most important safety feature of our new system is the dual action unlocking of the coppers, both on the hose and on the control unit. Turn the copper clockwise and the pressure is released, but the hose stays connected. If I turn it counterclockwise, I can safely disconnect the hose. Using the optional shutoff hose allows you to remove the hose line from the working area without having to deflate the bag. That's it for now. Watch more videos on our YouTube channel or contact your Holmatro dealer for a product demonstration. See you next time.